Can you tell we've done this before?
Alright, so hi, I'm Andres Cuervo, and I'm a front-end engineer at Circle CI. I've been doing this stuff on the side for about a year. My talk is called Virtual Reality on the Web Using A-Frame. And before we get into what A-Frame is, what is a VR display? This is a really simplified version. Generally, you have a head-mounted display that gives you a first-person, like, immersive experience, and some way of tracking, usually with a position sensor, some way of tracking where your head is, and most modern systems give you controllers that are trapped in space that simulate hand input. And so this is all very well and good, and a lot of people have been wondering how the web could help us handle this really new input system. And before I get into how A-Frame helps us do that, I just want to show off some work that people are doing using the entity component system in A-Frame. So a component can be a bunch of different things, and a lot of people are building various A-Frame components. There's the official A-Frame registry, which is a curated list of components, but people also post them on social media and on various Slack groups. A component could be something like this, which is an implementation of the Canon.js physics system. It could be something complicated like this, or something still complicated, but sort of on a more individual component basis. There's this example from the data arts team at Google implementing .GUI, which is a popular entity selector library. A component can be as extensible as an entire animation system, so A-Frame by itself ships with its own animation system, but some people decided that wasn't declarative enough, so there's this really beautiful declarative animation system. A component can do all of this on init, so it can actually start up, change the skybox, change the floor, with this really beautiful environments component example. Components can generate other components, so something like a particle system. Components can do really complicated, abstract away really complicated shader logic, like this ray trace example. Components can be a hidden collection of components. So there's this really interesting superhands component that in VR gives you hand interaction models, but also allows you to do things like drag blocks when you're on your phone. It handles a bunch of different types of input. And components can also build off of other components. So this UI widgets component builds off of the superhands component and gives you these fun little toggles and switches and buttons. And then there's the sort of work that I do, which is not as impressive as all the others, and is an implementation of generative art. So this is just one pattern called the 10-frame pattern that implements planes in random rotations. And in VR, this actually, it looks kind of lackluster in this GIF, but in VR, this component is actually looks like a 10-meter tall wall of planes, which I think is interesting. What is this system that everyone is hooking into to create all this content? At its core, A-Frame is a wrapper around something called the WebVR API, which is currently in its second draft stage, so it's on a standards track, but it's still pretty experimental, but it's still really useful today. It can do things like tell you what kind of hardware you're on, or even give you back the position of the head to sort of move around the camera. All that said, the WebVR API itself is still really low level, so A-Frame wraps up a lot of its logic and also gives us other stuff like multi-platform capability. If you send someone a link to an A-Frame scene, they'll be able to use it on their phone using their gyroscope by moving stuff around. They'll be able to use it on their desktop by walking around using their keyboard and looking around using their mouse. And like I already showed you, there's a really extensible entity component system concept. The most succinct definition for A-Frame that I have is that it's a reusable, extensible system for creating VR scenes on the web. This is what browser support currently looks like. It's fully implemented in Microsoft Edge and Firefox, and will hopefully come to the rest of the Chrome suite soon. Right now it's on Chrome for Android because of Daydream. And so this is one of the simplest examples for A-Frame, the sort of the canonical Hello World example. We can see that our VR scene is everything inside of this A scene tag, and it looks exactly like HTML, in part because that's the point. A-Frame itself implements the custom component spec, and so we can write things in a very declarative way like we would write any normal HTML. And inside we use other tags, so we can say things like give us a box and give it some position and rotation and some color, and we do that for a sphere, a cylinder. We turn over this plane, we rotate it 90 degrees to make a sort of floor, and then we set a skybox. And on the other side, aframe.glitch.me is this really simple example, you can see how it generates its own, just from this declarative, simple little 17-line example, we get some pretty complex geometry. And so I said that A-Frame is extensible and reusable, and I wanted to show how small the component could be. So this top little snippet of JavaScript gives us access to a new foo component. And on init, we could do anything. We could generate geometry, we could start a physics system, but here we're just saying init. We're passing in this tick function that on every frame, A-Frame ensures that this tick function will run and be in sync with the rest of our VR system, which is really nice because keeping things in sync is normally really hard. We're going to get the scale of whatever object we're bound to, and we're going to oscillate its scale. We're going to add its scale by some function of whatever t is at that time. And like I said, since it's just HTML, all we do is add foo as an attribute, and we get out this. It looks white here, but it's supposed to be a colored little box that's animated. That's a very basic component. And one last thing for people coming from bigger engines like Unity or Unreal is that having a GUI to sort of move objects around and having a panel to set things is really convenient if you don't want to go back into a script and debug stuff. And A-Frame has a similar concept for when you're doing more advanced VR work or more advanced scene work, and that's the inspector. There's a lot to dig into here, and that would probably be a talk in and of itself, but it's nice to know that exists. And then one last thing is that A-Frame, all of this, and A-Frame is only on version 0.7, so sometime next year, A-Frame will go out of beta and actually hit 1.0 and be battle-tested, and that stuff will be great. It can only go up from here, basically. And then on a more personal note, a lot of my recent A-Frame work has been exploring augmented reality and web AR. First doing just vanilla JavaScript with normal camera stuff, and then more recently using experimental browsers to hook into ARKit and AR4. So there is a lot of work left to be done with A-Frame, and if any of that sounded interesting, I would encourage you to take a look at it. Thanks.